Did You Know video series, Lung and Bronchus Cancer. Did you know that lung cancer is the leading cause of cancer death for both men and women in the United States? From 2009 to 2013, lung cancer caused more deaths than breast, prostate, colorectal, and liver cancers combined. In 2016, lung cancer diagnoses represented 13% of all new cancer cases in the U.S. This means that out of 100 people diagnosed with any type of cancer, 13 had lung cancer. There are two main types of lung cancer: small cell lung cancer and non-small cell lung cancer. Each type is named for the kinds of cells found in the cancer and how they look under a microscope. The cancer cells of each type grow and spread in different ways. The rates of new cases and deaths from lung cancer closely follow smoking rates. Between 1975 and 2013, diagnoses and deaths increased as smoking rates increased, and then decreased as smoking rates decreased. Smoking is the single most important risk factor for lung cancer. Quitting smoking greatly reduces, but does not eliminate, your risk of developing lung cancer. Lung cancer can also occur in people who have never smoked. Other risk factors for lung cancer include HIV infection, family history of lung cancer, and exposure to secondhand smoke, radon, asbestos, arsenic, chromium, nickel, soot, tar, radiation, or air pollution. The overall 5-year survival rate for lung and bronchus cancer is about 18%. This means that after adjusting for other causes of death, out of 100 people diagnosed with lung cancer, 18 had not died from this cancer in the 5 years since diagnosis. Survival is higher in patients with lung cancer that is detected before it has spread to other parts of the body. The U.S. Preventive Services Task Force recommends that adults who are at high risk for lung cancer get screened regularly. Talk with your doctor, especially if you have any of the following symptoms: cough that doesn't go away, gets worse over time, or produces bloody mucus, chest discomfort or pain, loss of appetite, or trouble breathing or swallowing. Quitting smoking is the most important step you can take to reduce your risk for lung cancer. With the right help, you can succeed. Visit smokefree.gov or call 1-800-44-U-QUIT for evidence-based tools, articles, and resources. Whether you choose an app, text message program, or online or telephone counseling with experienced QUIT counselors, smokefree.gov provides access to free, professional support to help you become and stay smoke-free. It's never too late to quit. No matter how much or how long you have smoked, there are benefits to quitting. Take the first step today. Researchers have developed FDA-approved genomic tests that help clinicians match lung cancer patients with specific treatment options based on which molecular changes their cancer has. This new approach to treatment that targets specific tumor characteristics is known as precision medicine. For more information about lung cancer treatment options, including current clinical trials, please visit cancer.gov. or call 1-800-4-CANCER. For additional cancer statistics, visit seer.cancer.gov. U.S. Department of Health and Human Services, National Institutes of Health, National Cancer Institute. Produced October 2017.